Hello guys, Adobe just dropped its most recent programming updates through the Creative Cloud, and among those updates is another component in Adobe Camera Raw ACR called Super Resolution. You can upsize an image 4 times while preserving its details and colors. For instance, you can turn a 10 megapixel image into 40 megapixel image and maintain its sharpness at a higher resolution, thereby improving its quality. Let's watch how this works. Most importantly, it works with any picture file regardless of whether it is a raw picture document, a TIFF document, or JPEG. You should open the picture file in Adobe Camera Raw through Photoshop or Adobe Bridge to get the super resolution. Include right click on the picture and select enhance. First, I am starting with the raw image. Later you can learn how can you open the JPEG image. So keep watching till the end. It is a very important to know how you can unlock the JPEG or TIFF image to open directly on RAW workspace. I am opening a RAW image of the cat that I have taken with my Nikon D90 12.3 megapixel camera. Zoom into the 100% to see its sharpness without any editing, and opening its Photoshop workspace. Zoom in up to 200% to show its pixels. To see its size, use Ctrl plus Alt plus I in Windows, or Command plus Option plus I in the Mac. You can see the image size is 4288 pixels on the longer side. Before new feature, normally we increase the size manually. So I am changing the value almost double, 4288 to 8400, and select the option Preserve Details 2.0. It takes little time and image converted to the super resolution. Preserve Details 2.0 option is the best option for the enlargement, but we need to some work on it. In the video, you can't see the more details. If you will see, image produce some noise after conversion. So I creating duplicate layer by using Ctrl plus J in Windows or Command plus J in the Mac, and converting to small object. By converting layer to small objects, you can change filter value anytime. So go to the filter menu, then select blur, and then select surface blur. Surface blur can denoise images while preserving edges. You can use it to fix noisy photos or smooth out areas with a similar color. I am keeping radius to 4 and threshold to 2. You can change according to your requirement and size of the image. But don't do too much hiding mask and duplicating again by using Ctrl plus J in Windows or Command plus J in the Mac. Go to the filter menu, then go to others, then select high pass. You will see the entire image turn a flat gray color. Not to worry, this allow you to see exactly what is being sharped. The high pass filter only sharpens edges, so anything that's not an edge becomes flat gray. The amount of sharpening you do will largely be image dependent as well as site dependent. I am using 2.6 radius value for this image because this image was in good quality. If quality is poor, you can increase the value 0.5 to 5 and then click OK. Change blending mode normal to overlay and create a black mask and paint over the black masks. Take care, foreground should be the white to reveal the changes. I am painting over the edges, hair and eyes of the cat that I want to sharpen. Now this process is completed, and I am saving this image on my computer. This was an old way to get super resolution. Now I am using the new enhanced feature. So opening the original 12.3 megapixel image again in the Camera Raw. Right click on the picture and select the new option enhance. A dialog window will come up so you can see how the image will look. The dialog will give you an estimate on how long it will take to create the new enhanced image, which will show up as a separate image file. Once you are ready, simply click the enhance button in the lower right hand corner. ACR start working in the background immediately to build the new image file, and it eventually appears right next to the original file wherever that one is stored. You can see the new file appeared, and I am opening both files on the Photoshop workspace. First, I am selecting an original file. You can see it has 4288 by 2848 pixels, means 12.3 megapixels approx. Now we check the converted image. Type Ctrl plus Alt plus I in the Windows or Command plus Option plus I in the Mac. It converted to 8576 by 5696, means it converted to 48 megapixel. Amazing. You will get an 48 megapixel image, means 4 times resolution with any low cost camera. Now I am copying the original image and pasting to the converted image, and you can see the difference that size almost 4 times larger than the original. Now see the difference of the image that we converted with the old method and with the new feature. Selected old super resolution image and zoom into the 100%. Both images are almost the same. In the new enhanced image, noise is a little less than the old super resolution image. But the main thing, we get the result with the single click. In the old method, we created 3 layers to achieve that result. I really impressed with the result, especially the cost of the camera price. Sometimes many pixels wasted when we crop for creating good composition. In this image, I am cropping the waste area that I don't need. After cropping, this image is still 5785 by 3922 means more than double, 22.2 megapixel approx. That was converted from 12.3 megapixels. I am placing an original image to the crop image. You can see the difference. Now I am going to tell you how can you open JPG image directly to the camera RAW instead of Photoshop workspace. So go to the edit menu, select preference, then select camera RAW. A dialog box will appear and select file handling. Select option automatically open all spotted JPG and select automatically open all spot TIFF. Click OK. Now every time you open JPG or TIFF, it will be opened in the camera RAW workspace. Now I am opening a model picture in JPG format and it is opening on the camera RAW workspace. Right click on the picture and select the new option Enhance. Keep click on the super resolution, then click on Enhance. Processing is starting, showing in the bottom. After few seconds, new image will be created in the DNG format in the same folder. I am opening the both images on Photoshop workspace, selecting the original image and by right click select the print size. That is already showing almost the same size. When I am selecting the super resolution image and selecting the print size, it was converted to larger size. Go to the window menu, then select arrange, then select to up vertical. Now you can see the difference of the both images on the same time. An original image size is 1920 by 2880 approx, means 5.5 megapixel image. Now I am selected the converted image. It was converted to 3840 by 5768, means converted to 22 megapixel image. Select original image again and zoom into 200% and then selected super resolution image to 200% and see the clarity. You can see image was not blurred and it has the same sharpness and get success to retain the artifacts of the image. If I zoom in the original image to the same level, an original image lose its clarity and going to pixelate. Now I am saving this image for the reference and try to see can we increase more resolution, because we can't choose enhanced feature on DNG file that we have already enhanced. So I am saving it in JPEG format and closing the DNG super resolution file and opening the same file that we saved in the JPEG format. Following the same process, right click on the picture and select enhance. Dialog box appeared and click on enhance, process begun and it was converted to the super resolution image of 22 megapixel image. I'm opening both images on the Photoshop workspace. So we have three images here. Original picture of 5.5 megapixel. Second image is a converted image of 5.5 megapixel to 22 megapixel picture. And new converted image that we converted from 22 megapixel resolution and selected print size of the each again. Then go to the window menu, select arrange, then select 3 up vertical. You can see the difference of the size of the pictures. If I zoom to the 100% of the new picture and clarity is almost same and keep the details. And image converted to 7680 by 11520 pixels means we have now 88 megapixel image and very little loss of artifacts. That's all for the today. Hope you like this video. If you have any question, kindly ask in the comment section. and kindly like and share the video to support my channel. So I will keep updating you and help me to reach my first goal of 5,000 subscribers. Thanks for watching.